In a forest, there lived a colony of crows on a huge banyan tree. A colony of owls lived in another tree nearby. The owls were powerful enemies, frequently attacking and harassing the crows. The owls could see at night, giving them advantage over the crows. The king of the crows called for a meeting with his ministers.
We can make peace with the owls.
But the wicked enemies, the owls, will never keep their promise. Can we move to another place? If the crows choose to move to another place, they will have to rebuild their lives once again. The new place could pose other problems.
Finally, an old crow came up with a novel idea.
Let us have the policy of double dealing.
What is that?
You attack me and throw me out of the flock. I will go and settle temporarily in the nearby mountain. I will try to gain the confidence of the enemies.
Where will you stay then?
I will stay with them and then tactfully destroy them.
Excellent idea! You can proceed.
The old crow picked up a mock quarrel with the king. The king punished him and he was thrown out. One of the owls saw the miserable fate of the old crow and hurriedly went to report the matter to his king.
Great king, I saw an old crow on the mountain. He is driven away by the king of crows. He is old and is starving for food. There is none to help them.
The king of the owls arrived at the spot. He saw the groaning old crow. He saw shelter with the owls.
Oh, king of owls, you are very great. But why have you come all the way to see me? No one likes me.
What happened?
When I asked our king to pay tribute to you, he kicked me out and almost got me killed. I have no place to go to. I seek your protection, O King. I promise to work for you in the destruction of the crows.
I feel bad. You can come and stay with me in my fortress.
O King, I am so very grateful to you, but I am not worthy of the honor of staying with you. After all, I am only a crow. Allow me to build my nest at the gate of the fort.
In fact, he did not want to stay too close to the owls, as he would be constantly watched and would not be able to carry out his plan of destroying the owls.
All right. You can build your nest wherever you want. The owls will take care of you.
Thank you. Thank you, great king.
The old crow made a big nest by laying dry twigs at the entrance of the owl fold. Then one morning, when the owls were sleeping, the old crow slipped out and flew straight to the nearby mountain where his friends were hiding.
Dear King, my plan has been successful. I am staying in the entrance of this fort.
What should we do now?
My lord, please instruct each of the crows to quickly pick up a burning twig follow me.
Wonderful! You go ahead. They will follow you.
The crows did as instructed and began to drop the burning twig into the nest of the old crow, which was nothing but a pile of old twigs. In no time, a huge flame sprang up. The owls woke up, but could not escape. The gate was shrouded by the flames, and smoke filled the fortress. In no time, the entire colony of owls perished.
Hooray! The owls are no more!
Excellent job! You have saved all of us! You will be our chief minister from today!
The crows left happily. A disloyal person who comes from the enemy camp should never be believed.